We're back in the Total Boat Shop with our third and final series on how to build and install a hardtop. In our previous segments, you've seen us lay up both panels, drill the holes, and finish the edges. So now we're ready to begin priming and painting prior to installation. We first sand the entire panel in preparation for priming. We then tape out the portion of the underside that's going to remain clear coated. We're using Total Boat Epoxy Primer. This is a one-to-one high build primer, which is very easy to mix and use. To apply the primer, we're using a 6-inch foam roller on the flat surfaces. We're then using a 1-inch foam brush to get the edges and other areas that the foam roller can't reach. We're going to apply our high build primer now. We're going to use a foam roller to get as much material down as quickly as possible on this large flat surface. We're going to apply multiple coats in order to fill the weave of the cloth and any surface imperfections that exist. A typical recoat time is about 45 minutes to an hour between coats, and we know that we're ready to recoat when the surface is tack-free. To get the best finish possible, we're going to spray on our two-part polyurethane paint in our paint booth. The paint booth gives us a dust-free environment, which ensures a perfect finish. After multiple thin coats have been sprayed on, we can remove the tape, and you can see the contrast between the carbon and the painted surface. We are now ready to clear coat the underside of the carbon panels. What we're going to use here is a clear coat all grip product, which is mixed two parts all grip to one part converter. We're going to roll and tip the clear coat onto the carbon panels, and so we're going to reduce the mixture with a 25% ratio before applying. Once all the product is added to the pot, we want to slowly mix the clear coat so that we don't stir up any bubbles. And then we want to wait about 5 minutes to let everything settle before actually pouring it onto the part. We're working on a flat surface, which makes the application easier. But at the same time, we don't want to pour out too much material because we want to quickly follow behind with the roller and the tip. As the clear coat goes down, you can really see the weave of the carbon cloth come to life. By working in small sections, we have plenty of time to follow up with the rolling and the tipping. For our application, one coat of all grip clear was all that was needed to create a high gloss surface. So now in the process, we have the first finished panel. We can admire the beautiful clear coat job that Brendan has done on the underside that highlights the weave of the carbon fiber. And what you're looking at is the perimeter of the aluminum frame. So basically what we're doing is transitioning from the clear coat carbon to the painted white once we get outside of the perimeter frame. And I wanted to briefly talk about why we went with a carbon laminate on this hardtop. Other than the fact that it looks really good, we wanted to keep the part as light as possible. Because it is up high, the lower the weight is up high, the more stable the boat will be, the less the boat will roll. And the other thing we were looking for is a dark surface on the underside of the hardtop so that you don't have any reflective glare when you're at the helm on a sunny day. And a black surface, or in this case, a black carbon surface, is a perfect low glare type of surface to minimize the reflected light at the helm. So now we're going to turn the panel around and I can show you the non-skid that Brendan painted on the top. So now we're looking at the top of the panel. You can see the two notches that we've cut to create clearance for the two aluminum arch tubes that go across the top of the arch and support the electronics. This is the back end of the panel. And that's forward. We have a little bit more overhang forward, so that's why you're seeing more white. So now the next step is we're going to carry the panel up onto the boat and slide it into place. And what we've done is we've put some foam padding on the top of the aluminum tubes, because as we slide the panel across, we want to make sure that we don't scratch the clear coat. The tubes are fairly smooth, but they're still, it has the potential of creating some scratches. So we want to protect the clear coat panel as much as possible until we get it into place. Then we'll pull the foam out of the way and start to fasten it down, and then bed the fasteners with Total Seal. We tighten down all the fasteners to pull the panel down to the aluminum frame, and then what we did is individually we went back, backed each one of the machine screws off and put some Total Seal underneath the head of each one of these pan head machine screws, then tighten it back down. Then that way we get a watertight seal around each fastener, and when there's rain and salt spray on the hardtop, we don't need to worry about that moisture getting down into the foam core of these panels. And it also makes the installation watertight. You can see what I had talked about earlier with the non-skid pattern being just inside the perimeter fasteners. And you could also see that when we bedded each one of the fasteners down, it was a lot easier to clean up the total seal around the heads of the fasteners that were on the smooth white surface as opposed to the non-skid, no-slip surface that just, it held a little bit more of the bedding compound. But overall, it all comes out nice and neat. So the next step is to install the starboard side panel, and then we'll install the 36-inch grab rails that are going to be used to tie down the forward end of the surfboards or whatever else we want to store on top of the hardtop. The last step will be to finish the seam down the center line between both panels. We're going to use a black silicone sealant on the underside of the panel, which will match the black carbon. As you can see, we've placed masking tape on both sides of the seam. This will help minimize the cleanup once we're done. On the top, we're using white Total Bond, and again, we've taped the seam to minimize cleanup. We now have a watertight top and bottom seal, which matches the colors of the panel. This completes the installation of the hardtop. We now have a nice rigid surface that we can walk on. The non-skid minimizes any slippage. Our grab rails give us a location to tie down surfboards or kayaks. And our low glare surface on the underside provides a comfortable helm. All that's left to be done now is to launch the boat and enjoy our time on the water.